Unstable angina, definition and pathogenesis. Following categories come under the group of unstable angina: angina at rest, new onset exertional angina, and recent acceleration of angina in the form of lowering of threshold, increase in severity, or new sites of radiation. Likelihood of significant coronary artery disease in those presenting with symptoms suggestive of unstable angina is higher in those with previous history of coronary artery disease, presence of risk factors for CAD, older age, and ST-TUA changes in ECG suggestive of ischemia. Following situations can precipitate unstable angina: inappropriate tachycardia as in anemia, fever, hypoxia, tachyarrhythmias, thyrotoxicosis; high afterload as in aortic stenosis, hypertension, and left ventricular hypertrophy; high preload as in high cardiac output and chamber dilatation; inotropic states like use of sympathomimetic drugs. Important prognostic predictors predicting poor prognosis in unstable angina are the presence of STT changes with pain, hemodynamic deterioration in the form of pulmonary edema, new onset mitral regurgitation, S3 and hypotension, left ventricular dysfunction, extensive CAD, age, and comorbidities like diabetes mellitus, chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, renal failure, and malignancy. Important pathogenetic factors leading to unstable angina are plaque disruption, acute thrombosis, and vasoconstriction in the coronary arteries. Plaque disruption can be active or passive. Passive plaque disruption occurs in the soft plaque with high concentration of cholesterol esters and a thin fibrous cap. Active plaque disruption occurs in macrophage-rich area with enzymes that may degrade and weaken the fibrous cap, predisposing it to rupture. Acute thrombosis can occur in the vulnerable plaque and systemic hypercoagulable states. The vulnerable plaque is disrupted plaque with ulceration. It occurs in 2/3 of unstable angina patients. The exposed lipid-rich core abundant in cholesterol ester is highly thrombogenic. In systemic hypercoagulable states, the plaque is disrupted with erosion. This occurs in 1/3 of unstable patients. Vasoconstriction of the culprit lesion occurs in response to deep arterial damage or plaque disruption in the area of dysfunctional endothelium near the culprit lesion. Platelet-dependent and thrombin-dependent vasoconstriction are mediated by serotonin and thromboxane A2. Please don't forget to subscribe to this channel for future updates and click on the bell icon for all updates. Thank you.